Good morning, friends. Today, at the end of this diode discussion, we would like to discuss about the clipper and clamper circuits. For the sake of the understanding, for clipper and clamper circuit, we would like to see some circuit in which the current as well as voltage and their combinations have to be discussed. So, let us start about the some circuit analysis using the diodes and these previous this background knowledge gives the ultimate consequence of the clipper and clamper circuit. So, let us see, this one is the first circuit. In the first circuit, the analysis is, here it is 10 volt DC supply connected with a resistance of 5 kilo ohm and two diodes A and B. So, if we say to find out the amount of current flowing in the circuit, then we can analyze the circuit as this is positive potential, this is negative potential. So, the current is flowing from positive terminal to negative terminal, and at this junction it will flow something like this, A and B. So, this point is positive potential and here it is the positive potential. If P and N are the terminals of the diode A, here it is P and N are the terminals of diode B, then this P is connected with positive, while this P, this N is connected with the positive. So, this diode A is forward bias and diode B is reverse bias. I mean, the resistance is approximately 10 ohm and the resistance reverse is approximately 1 mega ohm. This is RF forward. So, what will happen? This part is behave like on and this part is behave like off. So, this circuit is simplified by using this circuit something like this. This is 10 volt, here it is 5 kilo ohm, and this is the resistance RF of diode A. So, current I is equal to V over R, that is 10 volt plus 5 kilo ohm plus this is RF is 10 ohm. So, this value is 10 volt upon 5010. So, this is I is approximately 10 volt upon 5 kilo ohm and this is 2 milli ampere. The current flowing in the circuit is 2 milli ampere and the path of the current is something like this. So, this is the first circuit. In the second circuit, we see this is the 15 volt and this is 25 volt. So, the net potential net potential on the diode, net potential at the diode is equal to 25 volt minus 10 volt, that is 15 volt. And this 15 volt is plus 15 here. So, this P, and here it is N, this P is connected with the positive with respect to N. So, it is forward bias. So, the ultimate circuit will be, the ultimate circuit will be something like this. This is 15 volt, this is 5 kilo ohm, and this is again 10 ohm. This is R F. So, current I is equal to 15 volt upon 5 kilo ohm plus 10 ohm. So, this is approximately 15 volt upon 5 kilo ohm, that is 3 milli ampere. So, what we find? This is the direction of the current, that is I is equal to approximately 3 milli ampere anti clockwise. Well, in this case, if you find this is clockwise. So, these are the two circuit, and these circuit are analyzed. Now, comes to this circuit. In this circuit, this is AC potential. AC potential means there is a 0, here it is T by 2 and then T. This is positive and this is negative. So, this potential is positive. So, this will be forward bias, and here it is reverse bias. So, for the two part, first half cycle, the circuit we have this is A, and the second half cycle, the circuit is something like this. This is B. So, the current across this resistance, say load, is alternatively in the first cycle and in the second cycle. So, the output will be, what will be the output? The output will be, this is positive, then negative, and then positive, this positive and this positive from A diode, and in this case, this is negative, this negative, this is time omega t, this is V O, this is V O, this part is for this cycle. In this case, the circuit 4, as we see, this is 30 milli ampere current, then the potential drop, is 1 volt minus 0.7 volt, that is 0.3 volt. Where 0.7, this is V, VDO is 0.7 volt for silica, So, this drop is distributed on this resistance R L. So this V is 0.3 volt is nothing but I into R. This I is 30 milliampere and here it is R, this is 0.3 volt. So this R is 0.3 volt divided by 30 milliampere. This is milli, 10 to the power minus 3. When it comes to the upper part, it is the 0.3 into 1000 volt upon 30 A. So this is cancelled and 300 by 3. So this is 100 ohm. So this resistance is nothing but it is 100 ohm. This part. Now, in this circuit, this is the positive potential and here it is negative potential. So, if you say these are four diodes, this diode is say D1, this diode is D2, this diode is D3 and this diode is D4. So, D1, D2, D3, D4 are four diodes. And it seems that these four diodes are connected in Kirchhoff circuit. So, if this is positive potential, this is a positive potential and this is positive potential. Here it is P, here it is N. This means that this diode is forward bias and this diode is reverse bias. This diode is reverse bias. And in this case, here it is negative voltage, here it is negative voltage. So, this negative is connected to PN. So, this is reverse bias and this minus volt connected to N type, P type. So, this is forward bias. It means these two, D2 and D4. These two diodes are reverse bias configuration and diodes D1 and D4 are forward bias configuration. So, this circuit can be simplified as this is 10 volt and this diode circuit is something like this. This is simplified circuit. So, this is 20 ohm resistance. Here you say forward bias 10 ohm resistance. This is 10 ohm resistance. So, the current is I is equal to V over R, that is 10 volt upon this 10 ohm plus 20 plus 10. So, 10 volt by 40 ohm. This is cancelled, it is 0.25 ampere, that is I can be written as 250 milliampere. So, in this current circuit in this way 250 milliampere will be the current, that current is flowing in this direction. In this direction. This is the path of the current in the circuit. Reduced circuit can be explained. Now, this one is, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 diodes are connected in different combination. So, we have to analyze regarding the biasing. You see this one is a minus 10 volt and here it is grounded, so it is 0 volt. So 0 is more than 10. So this n, and here it is p. So n type semiconductor is at higher potential in comparison to p type potential. So what will happen if we see the block of this p and n, these are the CDR regions, here are the electrons, and these are the holes, so here it is minus 10 volt and this is 0. So what will happen? This minus 10 volt will repel the electron away from the junction. This is the junction, away from the junction. Therefore, electrons are moving towards the terminal. It is not moving towards the junction. So this is the direction of motion of electrons away from the junction. So this circuit is nothing but it is reverse bias. Now comes to this circuit. Here it is grounded, means zero potential, and this is plus 5 potential. This is N and here it is P. Again, if we draw the block, so we find this is N and this is P. This N is plus potential, here it is zero potential. So again, what will happen? Electrons are moving away from the junction. So this is again, this circuit is again reverse bias configuration. Now for this circuit, you see this one is a plus 10 volt and here it is minus plus 5 volt. This is plus 5 volt. So what will happen if you draw the block? This is N, here it is P, and these electrons are at plus 5 volt, here holes are plus 10 volt. So electrons are attracted towards the junction. So what will, this is the forward bias, because electrons moving towards the junction, upper side. These are the electrons which are moving upper side. Towards the junction means forward bias. This is away from the junction. These are the minus potential, this is plus potential. So this electron is away from the junction. So these two away from the junction, this electron see towards the junction. Now in this case, here it is minus 5 volt, this is minus 1 volt. So this is P type, here it is N type. Again, if we consider the block, these are the electrons, minus 1 volt, here minus 5 volt, here it is holes, P type, N type. So minus 5 volt repel more than minus 1 volt. So what will happen? These electrons are repelled away from the junction, and that's why this is the reverse bias. Here in case this is minus 10 volt, this is N, this is P, this is ground. So if we find this one is, here it is N, minus 10 volt, here it is 0 volt. So this minus 10 volt repel the electrons towards the junction. Electrons are moving towards the junction in comparison. So it is, this is forward bias. This is the forward bias. So on the basis of the electron motion within the circuit and block, we have these analysis. On the basis of analysis, we have read about the clamper and clipper and clamper circuit. This clipper circuit is a simple half wave circuit, half wave rectifier, because half part is clamped, half part is clamped, so it is the clipper circuit. Half part of the input voltage is completely clamped, completely clamped. So what will happen? This is your source, this is your diode D, this is your load. So what will happen in this case? This is your input, V input, and at this load the output will be, this is 0, this is T by 2, this is T, this is 3T by 2, this is T, this is T by 2, this is 3T by 2. So this output is this part. This output is this part. So what will feel? This VO, this is the potential VO, is clipped. This is clipped part. This is clipped part. And if we apply this diode something like this, in this circuit, here it is RL, this diode is DL, this is the input, this is input. So what will happen? This is when V is negative, then it will conduct. So at this situation, this part will be available. So what we find? We find that in this half, first half, we will get this part. We will get this part. So it is clipped. In the next half, that is negative portion, this we will have this one is. We will have this one is. We will have this one is. So this part is clipped. This part is clipped. This part is clipped. This is V0. This part is clipped, it is V0. Now we can also have the parallel combination. The parallel combination is something like this. In parallel combination, what will happen? This resistance RL. So, this path will be short circuited if it is positive. If it is positive, then it is short circuited. So, the current is flowing through this path. Means something, suppose this is 10 kilo ohm, this is 10 kilo ohm. So, what will happen? This equivalent circuit is something like this. Here it is 10 kilo ohm and here it is 10 ohm. Here it is 10 ohm. So, current is flowing through this part. This is the diode in this part, the current is flowing, where it is positive potential first half, this part. In other circuit, in this part, this way, in the same plus second half, what will be second half? This is the reverse bias, so it is open and the current is flowing through this part RL load, second half. So, virtually no current is here in the first part. Here it is, current is flowing in this way. In this case, when it is positive, so this part is reverse bias means this is open, this is first half, this is open R, so current is flowing in this direction, the current is flowing in this direction. So, half of the part is clamped. Now, we have clipper and clamper. So, for the clamping, we can have this circuit something clamper, this the same The same can be drawn as of the two circuits. One is having this For the sake of numerical part, if we apply, suppose this is 5 volt, this is 5 volt, and here the VRMS is 50 volt. This is your 50 volt. It is VRMS is 50 volt. So what will be the corresponding circuit? The corresponding part is zero, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Here it is minus 10, minus 20, minus 30, minus 40 and minus 50. So, in this case, when this one is the 5 volt, so this is equivalent to, this is equivalent to, this is VZ junction potential. This junction potential is very, very small. This junction potential is very, very small. And if we take the cut-in, so we can say 0.7 volt. And then this is the 5 volt. So, what will happen if we take this approximately, this is T by 2, this is T, this is 3T by 2. So, this is this is the case, that is here this is clamped, this is your clamped. In this case we can also have this diagram. This is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 volt. Here it is minus 10, minus 20, minus 30, minus 40, minus 50. This one. Here it is T by 2, this is T, this is 3T by 2. So, in this part, the circuit that is this part is clamped, that is clamped. This part is if you say VDS DC. So this is 2V upon pi. 2V upon pi, that is 2 into 50 upon 3.14 upon 3.14. So, this is approximately 64% of 50 volt. DC is 64. So, what will be happen? This is approximately 38 volt. This is something 38 volt. And VRMS, V by under root 2, V by under root 2 means 70% of V, that is 70 into 50, 70% of 50, so So approximately this is 35 volt. This is 35 volt. So in this way we can get the clipper and clamper circuit on the basis of this one. Now the application area. Application area, the most of the places where we want to remove the noise. So for the removal of noise voltage, for the removal of noise voltage, and that is noise spikes. That is noise spikes. So in the circuit where we want to remove the noise, then we use the this kind of the circuit, clipper and clamper circuits in the diode application. So with the analysis of the diodes and its application area are very important for us. So this is all about the diode discussion. On the next module, I would like to start the big field for the electronics, that is transistor. Good. Thank you.